is Tesamorelin FDA approved? Now, the good news is, yes, it is FDA approved, and in this video, I'm going to show you the benefits of Tesamorelin, who it's for, but I'm also going to show you some of the nuances and how challenging it is to get FDA approval for virtually anything. But I'll also allow you to know exactly what Tesamorelin does, if it's right for you, and how you can access it. So let's jump in. I'm Regan Archibald. I am the founder of the Ageless Future Centers, and we help people achieve their greatest levels of health at any age. I mean, we just hosted this brain summit, and we had one of our clients, Linda, who had very poor mobility. She had cochlear implants earlier on in her life, and so she was gaining visceral fat. She was getting more loss of balance, and she was losing strength. And the crazy thing that's happened to her over the course of a few years is she's lost about 50 pounds. She can dead hang. Remember, she's almost 80 years old. She can dead hang 1 minute and 53 seconds. Can you dead hang that long? I know for me, it's like I can do it, but it takes an enormous amount of effort. I'm 30 years younger than she is. So it's phenomenal when you see these changes. Tesamorelin is one of those peptides that radically transformed her muscle mass and helped her get rid of that visceral fat. So as you talk about the FDA approval, one of the interesting things is this drug was approved, I believe it was 2012, under the brand name Agrifta. And this was a treatment that was utilized for HIV-infected patients. And what these patients were experiencing was this process called lipodystrophy. So they had a lot of fat that was accumulating around their organ systems. So their bellies became distended. They were losing muscle mass. They noticed their brain didn't work as well. And by using Tesamorelin, they said, well, what if we have a peptide that works on the growth hormone pathway? Will that help these patients? And what they found in the clinical studies is a lot of these patients had these fibrotic livers. Livers were really inflamed. They also noticed they had high cholesterol, high triglycerides. And after the course of 6 to 12 months, these patients had a loss on average of 19% of their visceral fat. Their fibrotic livers improved. Sometimes in 3 months through an MRI scan, they saw that the liver had a complete regeneration. They also found a 20% lessening of triglycerides and lowering of their overall cholesterol. That Agrifta product is very expensive. And, it's upwards of, in one of the studies I found, the public price shows basically $7,486 for a 30-vial kit. And what that equates to is every day you're doing one of these vials. So that's over $30,000 a year. And the reason why pharmaceutical companies are, charging the prices they are is because a lot of time your health insurance kicks in and you think, oh, well, my insurance will pay for it, therefore it's less expensive. But we're all paying one way or the other. And it's too bad because so much of that fee goes to administration costs and very little of it goes to new development and research. The other reason why it's so expensive is because it's almost $1 billion to get a drug to market. And hopefully with AI, this will be sped up. But the crazy thing about that is now the pharmaceutical companies have put money into it. They want to get an ROI, just like any other business would. But this is where compounding pharmacies come in. And we use only licensed 503A, 503B pharmacies. And what that does is it maintains the quality of the peptide, but it also ensures that you're getting the safest version of it so that it's not a research-based peptide. Now, FDA approval is very challenging, and I see in the future, right now there's roughly 126 peptides that are FDA approved. Many that you know, like Ozempic or Mounjaro, these are what are considered GLP-1 agonists, and GLP is a natural peptide made by your body. Now, when these pharmaceutical companies, when they get the patent on it, a lot of people will say, well, you can't patent peptides because they're natural. Well, you can patent the administration of anything that you've taken down that track to treat a specific condition. An FDA approval means that you now have the drug that treats a medical condition. And that's where with this lipodystrophy with HIV patients, that's what Tesamorelin is actually FDA approved for. Now, once a drug is FDA approved, then you can do off-label prescriptions, and there's almost more drugs that are used off-label than they are for the actual indication, and that's where it's called the practice of medicine. So a lot of our doctors who have licensing and prescriptive abilities at Ageless Future, what they'll do is we will look at your labs, and then we'll look at where the imbalances are, and we'll be able to see, okay, is Tesamorelin right for you? Is the GLP-1? Maybe we'll do like a tirzepatide and we'll stack it with carnitine so you can maintain some of the muscle, and we'll utilize that. And what we find is that if you can use the right data, match it with your goals, that's when you can see the biggest benefit from these beautiful substances. So FDA approval, the benefit of it is it does show that it's gone through human clinical trials. And this is where a lot of skeptics, when it comes to peptides, they say, we just don't have enough data. We don't have enough human clinical trials. And I was recently in the documentary on Make America Healthy Again. And one of the things that I'm encouraging us to look at, now that we have the ability to aggregate so much data, is to work with clinics like mine. We've been using these peptides for over a decade. They have a very safe profile, and they have a high level of efficacy, far greater than any other medicine that I've seen. And so when we look at the ability to get FDA approval, maybe that could be some of the criteria, because in these double-blind clinical controlled trials, a lot of times you're trying to remove as many variables as possible to see if that one agent made the difference. And what we've seen in peptides or natural medicine, if you're doing this, we always encourage you, and almost we demand it, if you're going to work with us, you got to do the exercise, you got to eat right, you got to get the right mindset, have the right habits in your life where you can really benefit from these peptides. And that's real medicine. That's real life, is where you know your body is a laboratory, and you know if you exercise more, you're going to feel better. You know, if you're doing your breathing, your meditation, if you have love and kindness to other people, if you fully express who you are as a human, you're going to feel better. And then the peptide is just the catalyst. So FDA approval, I love and I respect the process. Here's some of the studies that I'm going to dive into on how Tesamorelin actually got FDA approval. This study, it was published in The Lancet. And it says the effects of Tesamorelin on non-alcoholic fatty liver disease and HIV. This was randomized, double-blind clinical study. And what they found is it was indication would be the medical condition it's FDA approved for, which was for VAT reduction in HIV lipodystrophy. VAT is an acronym for visceral adipose tissue, the dangerous kind that causes a lot of inflammation. The approval was based on two multi-center randomized phase 3 clinical trials. The cohort was 806 people, showing significant VAT reduction of 15% at 26 weeks, so that's in about a half of a year, with effects maintained 52 weeks in extension phases and a favorable safety profile. Beyond that, the independent clinical research shows liver benefits. Another study, a JAMA, Journal of American Medical Association, randomized trial for 6 months demonstrated reductions in liver fat. NIH reported Tesamorelin reduced hepatic steatosis and prevented progression of fibrosis in people with HIV. Additional work in The Lancet, where they studied HIV patients, showed non-alcoholic fatty liver disease improvements. So once again, this is how we build trust in the robustness of Tesamorelin. Here's another pooled phase 3 random clinical trials. This was from 2010. Significant VAT reduction versus placebo. The extension showed durability and acceptable safety over 52 weeks. The extension meaning when they were out of the trial, they still maintained their body composition. And there was no profile that showed that, you know, they developed cancer, heart disease, or any other diseases. And that was from the Oxford Academic. Here's another study. This was phase 3 multi-center double-blind placebo-controlled trial with a safety extension. You know, that's on the back end looking at these patients after they're off the medication. 52-week analysis confirmed continued VAT control. They track glycemic effects, so very beneficial for blood sugar. Neutralizing antibody rates were low, so that means that their body didn't reject it and it didn't blunt the VAT response. So this study is titled The Immunodeficiency Virus-Infected Patients with Excess Abdominal Fat, a pooled analysis. So, and then finally, this one was from 2014, published in the Journal of American Medical Association, randomized clinical controlled trials. reduced liver fat, they had reduced liver fibrosis progression, benefits in non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, and this study was titled The Effects of Tesamorelin on Non-Alcoholic Fatty Liver Disease and HIV. So if you're thinking of tesamorelin being FDA approved, once again, it's so good for muscle gain, great for your body composition, awesome for your brain. So many benefits, like our patient Linda, who I love and admire, who's doing a minute and 53 dead hang. Good for you, Linda, and good for those of you who are watching this, because I know you're engaged in your health and you want to take it to the next level. And it's really nice to have the FDA approval. My hope and my dream and the thing that we're working at is getting more of these peptides where we have the same volume of data that we do for tesamorelin. So if you love this video and you want to go deeper, please share it with your friends, family, loved ones. Don't forget to subscribe so that you can see all the cool things that are coming out in this beautiful world of peptides and regenerative medicine. And by the way, I've got a free gift for you. Just click on the link below and you can get a copy of my book, The Peptide Blueprint. Easy to download. You can have it instantly. Appreciate you guys. I'm Regan Archibald. I'll see you on the next video.